Well, my name is Kelly Grimshaw. I'm a nurse and a nurse practitioner from the United States. I've been working with MSF since 1999 and been a nurse, a project coordinator, and a medical coordinator. I went to Indonesia in the late fall of 2001, I believe, to take over as project coordinator for an ethnic conflict where the Dayak population had been targeting the Madurese population, killing them with machetes basically in the streets. They were rescued by the Indonesian army and brought to Pontianak and West Kalimantan, which we would know better as Borneo, here in the States. And by the time I had gotten there, the refugee camps were set up, or the IDP camps were set up in sporting arenas and public event arenas, which upset the local population who no longer had access to their sporting places. And what we did was basically continue their access to healthcare and protection against the local population, the Dayak population, which continued to issue threats to them, and to make sure that the government was doing what they promised to help them. The basic kind of hands-on day-to-day care was assistance with clinics, concentrating on diarrhea and skin diseases, which were a bit rampant in the camps, and then providing water sanitation. So that was an ongoing basis. And then the other aspect was context analysis and protection. We knew that this population was not wanted where they had lived. We knew that when they came to Pontianak, they were not welcomed. Local population, government authorities, they were just a big headache. And that, again, the camps had been attacked a time or two, so we were there for basically protection. It was probably one of the hardest projects that I've done. Civil conflicts are scary, but people's animosity towards each other is usually related to a political point of view and not just based on who you are. And having said that, the local population was not happy with Doctors Without Borders protecting these people who were not wanted. And myself as an individual, as an American after 9/11, also played an impact where people would comment to me on the fact that I was American, what was I doing in Indonesia, and specifically why was I working with the Madurese. So it was an example where Doctors Without Borders was not universally loved in that particular situation. But we felt it necessary that there was a group without a voice and without any protection that needed our presence there. And they appeared, as the Madurese as a population, to be thankful for our presence.